Hello guys, welcome back to Tesca Technologies Private Limited. My name is Shivam Vijay and today in this video I am going to giving a demonstration on study of operation amplifier trainer. We'll see the different working modes of operation amplifier in this video. We'll see the different objectives, how to use the operational amplifier as integrator, summer, scalar, voltage follower and some other characteristics also of the op-amp amplifier. An op-amp or operational amplifier is a basically very important part, and or we can say that it is the heart of nowadays in analog computers. There are widely used operational amplifier with a large amount of negative feedback. Amplifier basically used for performing the different type of mathematical operation like addition, subtraction, comparison, multiplication, integration, differentiation, oscillators, or sometimes for generation of the different type of carrier waveforms. These are the different type of operations and needs of the operational amplifier which are basically used in any analog computer. So some of the basic mathematical operation which we are going to perform on this trainer board and study different operations of operation amplifier through this. So now let us move on to the kit. I will explain you all the components of this trainer board, and later on we will perform some important applications and operations given in the user manual. Follow the circuit, build up the circuit using all the components with the operational amplifier. So this is our main trainer board. The close look of this trainer board is study of operational amplifier using UA741IC. So 741IC is used for the basic operational amplifier, which is an 8-pin IC. All the detailed description about ICs, all the data sheet of ICs given with the user manual, you can study it in this so that you can find out all the important aspects of this operational amplifier. Apart from that, for building up some important circuits, we have provided some components on board with the terminals, of course. So we have provided 2.2 microfarad at 25 volts capacitor, electrolytic capacitor inside this, so that you can use it in the circuit for performing different type of operational circuits. This is a 1 mega ohm resistance. Then we have 100 kilo ohm resistance, 220 kilo ohm resistance, 220 kilo ohm resistance another, and a 2M2 resistance. The important feature is the dual port of 1M2 dual port. It has the capability of two potentiometers, two variable resistance separately, or when you connect them in series, you will get up to 2 mega ohms of the resistance variable, so that you can find out all the different type of variable feedback resistance to providing it in the circuits. Onboard 12 volt plus and 12 volt minus supply provided directly on the IC of operational amplifier, so that you can use it to the supply and directly internally connected. Input terminal for the op-amp supply, terminal number negative for 2 number pin, 3 number pin is provided on board on the socket. Output IC terminal 6 number pin of the IC is also provided. Ground is separately provided so that you can easily connect any of the circuit. Then we have 150 PF picofarads capacitor and 150 picofarad capacitor. Two of them are also provided separately for building up the circuit. This is the main power on off circuit socket over here, so that you can turn on and off the kit. The order code of this complete setup is 36172. You can use this to find out all the specification about this trainer and what you can learn from this trainer board by visiting our website, which is www.tescaglobal.com on the webs. So this is all about this. You required a function generator for providing the separate input supply and a CRO or DSO for observing the output, a digital multimeter for observing the output voltage, and a digital or variable IC regulated DC supply to providing the input voltages at different terminals and different points on the circuit that we are going to build in this complete practical video. User manual consisting of all the information about the complete Circuits and the experiments are given in the user manual and some patch codes for building up the circuits on board, and these are all included with this kit so that other of things like CRO or function generator are optionally required. If you have available at your place, you can use them. If you do not have them, you can also purchase it with along with the kit but separately. So this is all about the main overview and about the component and circuit of this kit. Now we move on to the practical sessions. We will follow all the practicals, build up the circuit on board, and then we create and generate output according to the operational amplifier operations. Now moving to first experiment. The first experiment is object study of op-amp 741 as integrator. So the circuit is given in the user manual. We have to build up the circuit as same on the trainer board. Then we have to provide the square wave input between terminal M and V, and we'll observe the output between terminal number 6 and V and oscilloscope, and output should be shown in figure. So square wave will our input as indicated, and output will our triangle wave, as we are going to integrate the square wave. This should be output is ramp for that. Now we will first build up the circuit on the trainer board, then we power on the circuit and follow the instruction as given in the user manual. Provide square wave supply to the input and get the output on oscilloscope. So as in the circuit, we have to use the complete 2M2 resistance. So first we will short circuit N terminal with R terminal so that both the 1M and 1M ports or potentiometers are combined in series, and we will get 2 mega ohm at the variable resistance. Now we'll connect V point with the third number pin of the op amp, and now we'll connect Q point at the second number pin of the op amp. Now from the Q point as well, we'll connect it to the I point at the capacitor, and from capacitor we'll connect J point to the E node or 6 number pin of the op amp amplifier. Now we'll provide input from the function generator as a square wave of some specified amplitude, and we'll get the output connecting the output probe on ground and E node on the oscilloscope. So now as we have set the square wave of 1 kHz in the function generator with the amplitude about 2 VPP, this is the input that will be provided on M terminal, as we have connected it on the M terminal already, and the ground will be going to the V terminal, which is a common ground for all the inputs. Now for observing the output, we'll connect the CRO probes on the output and we'll power on the circuit and check the output. So here trainer is turned on right now, and now we will check the output on the CRO. This is the square wave. If you adjust the dual port as I have already adjusted it, the triangular wave also changes, because we need to provide specified resistance, which is the input resistance to this. Here you can see is if I increasing the resistance, the output is going disappear, and as we are reaching about the specified resistance, the output is perfect. And if I almost more decreasing the resistance, the output changes to square again. So we need to provide a specified resistance as an input to get the proper triangular output waveform. So that's how we perform the integrator operation using operational amplifier. Now moving to next experiment, we are going to perform the op-amp operation as a differentiator. We'll make the circuit as given, and then we provide square wave frequency less than 100 kilohertz, 100 hertz and 5 EPP input between terminal I and V, and we observe the output at 6 and V on the oscilloscope. Output should be as an impulse waveform of output. This is a square waveform over here, and this is the circuit that need to be built on the strainer. So we'll do the connections according to this. So for this we also need to use the 2M2 port, the complete 2 mega ohms of capacity. So we'll short circuit terminal N and R, and we'll start with I and J as the capacitor is used on the input. So J terminal will be going to connect on the second number pin of op-amp, and similarly M, which is the variable resistance, is also need to connect on the second number pin. Now we'll connect Q, which is the output of potentiometers, will be going to output pin 6 number pin of the op-amp, and now we'll provide ground to third number terminal. So this is it, all the circuits is complete. Verify circuit with the circuit given in the user manual before turning on the kit, and now we'll ready to provide the input at I and V terminal, and output will be taken on E and D V terminal. So now we have set the 100 hertz square wave and 5 EPP output on the function generator. So we'll connect the function generator at the input terminals, ground on the V, and input at I in the negative of capacitor. And for checking output on the CRO, we'll connect output terminal on the CRO. So here you can see that these are the impulses that can be vary with the potentiometer. Now moving to the object number 3, study of op-amp 741 as a scalar and summer. The circuit is provided in the user manual. We will build the circuit similarly as given, and we'll apply sine wave of 1 volt RMS approx between E and V at the input, observe the output across the 6th and V number terminal, and vary the value feedback resistance by varying 2.2 mega ohm potentiometer. Output will be 10 times more than the value of potentiometer resistance. You can also verify the scalar function by applying 1 volt DC, output will be 10 volt DC when RF will be 2.2 mega ohms. So sine wave will be applied as per the practical. We will do the practical same for the 1 volt input from a DC power supply regulated. So we'll build the circuit, provide 1 volt supply to the input, and get the output should be around 10 volts. Now for making the circuit, first of all we'll short circuit the N and R terminal as we required 2 mega ohm potentiometer for this. Now we'll connect F terminal to M terminal. This is the F over here, we'll connect this to M. Q will be connected with the 6 number pin of the output. Now we'll connect 3 number terminal directly to ground. And this is all about this circuit. Now we'll provide input at E terminal of 220 kilo ohm resistance and V of the ground as 1 volt from the DC power supply. So we'll turn on the DC power supply. First we'll connect the terminals to this This is a dual channel DC power supply, which is separately you can need. You can provide 1 volt supply from any other source also. So we'll connect the input to the E terminal. Patch code is slightly loose, and we'll connect it to the ground. Now we'll turn on the power supply and adjust the voltage to 1. We'll also connect the multimeter to observe output. On the output terminals, always verify your connections after doing it, and then you will ready to do the practical. Sorry, there is a connection that we have forgot. We do not put any input to the terminal, so we'll connect M terminal to input terminal. Here the input is now connected. Now we can set the power supply at 1 volt and observe the output at multimeter. Now we are ready to perform the practical. First we'll turn on the trainer gate, and now we'll turn on the power supply. This is the first channel of this power supply that is set to 1 volt over here. This is the 1 volt DC output which is going to E terminal and ground. Now right now you can see there is no output on the digital multimeter. As we increase the resistance, the RF is increasing and we are getting output as per the value of RF. When you completely increase, the value will be around 2.2 ohms, or as this is the potentiometer in the component and electronics, the potentiometer does not have proper output values. So this is offering around 2 ohms of the value, and at 2 ohms we are getting around 9.15 volts, which is the scalar output of this op amp trainer. You can also perform this experiment on the functionator and CRO. You can provide a 1 volt sine wave to the input and you will get the 10 times or multiplied by feedback resistance value of the amplitude in the CRO also. Now for the summing amplifier, we'll connect one more 220k resistance in series with the other one, and we'll provide 1 volt at each of them, and then we get output on the output terminal. So there is a slight modification that we need to do for this. For converting this circuit as a summer, just connect 220 ohms other end, or connect F point with the D point, and now we can provide one more 1 volts input from the supply, as we have a 2 channel power supply. So we'll connect one channel to the E point, another channel to the C point, and we'll connect ground with the ground terminal. Output and multimeter is already connected. Now we turn on the DC power supply, adjust the voltage 1 volt on both the channels, and then we provide and see output. So now we'll turn on the trainer gate first, turn on the supply. This is the channel 2 voltage 1 volts, and this is the channel 1 volts 1.0 volts. Both channels are offering 1 volts. Now at the output we'll closely increase the resistance, and output is increasing as per the different inputs and feedback resistance values. Here you can see now output is increased slightly more than when we add the input resistance in parallel. So input resistance slightly goes down and we have output increased up to 12 volts. So that is how we add the and summing of the two voltages going on through this operational amplifier as summer. Now moving to next experiment, we are going to build the Wien's bridge oscillator We'll make the circuit as given in the user manual. The circuit is on the next page. So this is the complete circuit that we are going to build up, in which the mention is 2M2 over here, but we will use only two ports separately, 1M to 1M, and this is just for indication, 2M2, don't confuse with that. And we'll get the output on the oscillator, which is a sine wave, by adjusting the potentiometer. So that will build up the circuit, and Wien's bridge oscillator will oscillate sine waveforms for a specified frequency. Now for building up this circuit, we'll start connecting the patch cores as given in the circuit diagram. So we'll start with M will be connected with P over here, and M will also connected with K. Now we'll connect K, L with N. Now L will connected with T also. Other end of the T, S, which will be connected with the H, the 2M2 resistance. And H will be connected with the, which is a short point of S, and H will be connected with the input of the op amp. Now we are going to connect G, other end of the H, to the Q point, and R will be connected with the P. Sorry, R will connected with O, so that capacitor 150 ohm will be added in the circuit. Now we take a point from P, and this will be connected on the non-inverting input of op amp, and make sure N, L, T will be short with the V terminal. So we'll short the L terminal with V, so that L, which is connected with N, will be going to short. And there is a connection that we forgot also, which is G will be going to connect with output. Always verify your connection with the circuit before turning on the trainer board. Now I have turned on the trainer board, and we will observe the output on the CRO. Now we will take the output on the CRO. For this we will connect ground of the CRO on the ground, and test probe on the output terminal of the op amp. Over here you can see this is the sine wave oscillations. Adjust the port for adjusting the proper sine wave. You will get a very fine adjustment you need to do for getting the proper sine wave. And here it is. There is slightly waveform clipped. So this is the output from the resistance specified on the circuit, but we can also improve the sine wave by adjusting the resistance's value. You can use 100k instead of 1m and 220k instead of 2 mega ohms, and let us see what is the variation due to this on the waveforms. For this, we'll just pulling out the 1 ohm resistance and connecting 100k, and the 2 ohm resistance will be used 220k. And now we'll adjust the potentiometer and let us see if we can find out the proper and clean sine wave on the output. Here you can see the sine wave is slightly more clean, and you can adjust it to proper without clip output as well, like this. So just need to adjust the potentiometer for getting the proper output. So that's how we made the circuit for Wren's bridge oscillator. Now, in the experiment number 5, we'll study the differential input amplifier. We'll make the circuit as given in the user manual, and then we'll make the circuit connections and apply different input DC voltages, say 2 volts and 3 volts to C and E, and we note the DC output voltage as multimeter. Using a multimeter, this will be the amplified value of difference of two inputs. So in this, we'll need to use M and N without shorting it. So we'll working on 1 mega ohm on both the side, and then we'll use 220 kilo ohm resistance with C and D and E and F terminal, and we'll get output while providing different voltages at input terminals. For this, we are going to first build the circuit. So we'll start with D point, which is connected to M, and this short point of D to M is going to input as 2 number pin also. Now we connect F point with Q, and R will be going to V, and also Q point is going to the non-inverting terminal of this op-amp, and N terminal is going to the output terminal of this circuit. So over here our circuit is complete. Verify the circuit from the user manual before turning on the kit, and if you are not getting your output properly. Now, as we have to provide two different voltages at C and E terminal, so we'll connect DC power supply, which have two channel. You can use two separate DC power supplies also. We'll connect it to the ground, and first one to the C, and second channel will be going to connect on E, and negative will be connected on ground. So this is how we are going to connect. Now we'll set the input voltages on both the channels separately and get the output on the multimeter. So we'll turn on the trainer kit first. Now we'll turn on the power supply and set the voltage at channel 1. We're providing 2 volts. So we have set the channel 1 at 2 volts carefully, and channel 2 will be set at 3 volts. So here this is up to 3 volts right now. Now we'll check the output on the multimeter. For this, we'll just slightly adjust the multimeter. Sorry, we do not connect the multimeter still. That's why we are not getting the output. So we'll connect the multimeter first, and we'll see the output from 0 resistance. टू मैक्सिमम। हियर 4.86 इज अ एम्पलीफाइड आउटपुट ऑफ बोथ द इनपुट टर्मिनल्स। नाउ फॉर द लास्ट एक्सपेरिमेंट विच इज वोल्टेज फॉलोअर सर्किट, वी विल मेट द सर्किट एज गिवन। विल अप्लाई साइन वेव अक्रॉस 3 वोल्ट्स एट पिन नंबर 3 एंड वी एंड विल गेट द ऑब्जर्व आउटपुट ऑन द 6 नंबर एंड वी ऑन द ऑसिलोस्कोप। आउटपुट विल बी द सेम फेज एज इनपुट। सो दिस इज द वोल्टेज फॉलोअर सर्किट ऑफ द ऑप एम्प, वर्किंग ऑफ ऑप एम्प कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एज अ वोल्टेज फॉलोअर। सो वी जस्ट नीड टू कनेक्ट 2 नंबर पिन विद द 6 नंबर पिन and then we provide input and get output on the oscilloscope. For making the connection, we just connect 2 number pin with the 6 number as an output. Now we'll provide input at V and 3 number pin and we'll get output on 6 number and V terminal, which is ground. So now we have set the function generator as a sine wave of 1 kilohertz and 3 VPP. Now we'll connect ground to V terminal and input to 3 number terminal, and for making the voltage follower output, we'll connect ground on the ground terminal and test probe on the output terminal, and when we turn on the kit, we'll get the proper sine wave output on the oscilloscope. Right now the oscilloscope set at 0.5 divisions volts per divisions. So in positive, if we see, we have received around 1.5, as 3 divisions are receiving on the displayed waveform. Similarly, 3 divisions in the negative are also receiving, which is about 1.5 volts in negative. So if we can see, the 1.5 plus 1.5 is equals to 3 volts we peak to peak that we are going output over here, and it is in the same phase of the input waveform. We'll see the input waveform also, which is same. So that's how voltage follower circuits work, and this is the last application of this op amp application trainer. Of this study of operational amplifier with different modes are now completed. We have explained all the experiments provided in the user manual in this video, so that you can get the complete practical hands-on experience on the different type of modes, how the operational amplifier works in the analog computer in different modes. You can perform all the experiments as described in the user manual. Refer the user manual, refer this video that we have made for your support. And if you still find the 4 difficulties, you can contact to Tesca Technologies Private Limited for all type of supports. And if you like the content of this video, if you find it useful and get some knowledge about the operational amplifier, how the operational amplifier works in different type of modes, you can like the video, and also you can share this video to your friends, to your colleagues, to your classmates, those who want to learn about this type of operational amplifier working in the different modes. Also, you can subscribe our channel, which is Tesca Tech on YouTube. There are a lot of videos with the different type of educational trainer, with the practical hands-on experience with highly educated persons are explained, so that you can clear your concepts for different type of education related topics. And don't forget to press the bell button, so whenever we upload our new video, you will get to notify about that. You get the notification about the new trainer that we introduce. You get the knowledge about of new technology on the trainer as well.